Today in the 5-minute saltwater aquarium guide, just when you thought that you had this reefing thing down, the water starts to yellow and needs to be polished. Today we show you how to maintain crystal clear water in these two reef tanks. Hey, I'm Ryan, your host of BRStv in the 5-minute saltwater aquarium guide. This is a clear, simplified, and direct path to setting up a first successful reef tank. It's time to talk carbon and a couple other things to keep the water pristine. These are 2-minute tasks and super cheap, but you have to know what to look for, both in terms of when to do it and what success looks like. Today, we're gonna hand over those tools and the knowledge of what to do. The challenge here is while the skimmer and water changes keep overall water pollutants down, neither will prevent the water from yellowing over time. Yellow water is just the end result of organics, food, and fish waste breaking down. The yellow water is not just visually undesirable, but also blocks light from penetrating the water and reduces the energy to the corals. Overall, yellow water is just representative of general poor water quality and often associated with undesirable odors. Because the lights in our tanks are so blue, it's often hard to see with the human eye how yellow the water's really become. You can see it best when the tank lights are off and you look through the tank, particularly through the sides of the tank, where you're looking through more of the water and you can see how yellow the room looks on the other side. However, the best time to see is actually when you do your water changes. Put your new bucket of freshly made salt water next to the water you take out of the tank. If they don't look the same, it's time to polish the water. Running some carbon will turn the water back to its original pristine blue state. In fact, next time you run some carbon the day before your water change and you'll see how visually the old water and the new water look nearly identical this time. The media we've been talking about is activated carbon. Carbon's the most widely used water filtration media on the planet and used in all kinds of industries. You've probably seen carbon in your drinking water filters. In RODI systems, they're that second and sometimes third filter. Under that paper is a solid carbon block or cylinder. The carbon media is just a vast microscopic pore network designed to adsorb pollutants. The media has so much surface area, it's somewhat difficult to grasp. In fact, a single teaspoon of carbon has as much surface area as an entire football field. That's partially what makes it so good at removing these common water pollutants. In an aquarium, most reefers simply drop in a filter bag of carbon into a high flow area of the sump or tank, or better yet, run it in a reactor which pumps water through the media, the most common being a BRS reactor just because they're affordable and the small canister cartridge combo is easy to clean and maintenance. However, in these two tanks, I'm just gonna do it a bit different. On the 40 breeder, I'm gonna use a $30 Eheim Liberty hang on the back power filter just because it's significantly cheaper than a reactor and pump. Second, because the hang on design is a lot easier to install. And lastly, it's just a cleaner install. Eheim Liberty filter just sets on the back, plug it in and prime it. Inside are pleated filters with activated carbon. These little cartridges will not only polish the water, but also reduce floating particulates in the water as well. Once they wear out, just replace the cartridge. However, much cheaper and probably better ways to put a small bag of carbon back there. A 4x8 mesh bag with drawstring will work well. And the best carbon we sell for this is the ROX 0.8 for around 20 bucks. ROX 0.8 is designed for the pharmaceutical industry for purity, has the widest array of pore sizes for effectiveness and efficiency with common contaminants. ROX is also one of the hardest or lowest dust carbons out there, so it's easy to rinse and use. A quarter cup of carbon is probably adequate, and the small container will probably last you most of the year on these tanks, so like a buck and a half a month. The simple bag of carbon is actually what we're going to do on the E170 as well. However, in this case, the back sump compartment has a media tray which will hold our carbon bag. Pop it in and slide it down. The baffle system in the back will ensure water flows through it. A nice, clean, inexpensive way to do this. With both the Liberty filter and the E170, before you use the carbon, make sure to run it under some cold water in the bag until the water runs clear and all the dusty fines are out. If you're looking for best practice, you can rinse it in RODI water, but I've personally always done it in tap water just because it's faster and easier. As a rule of thumb, I change it out every couple to a few weeks, but more precisely, when you see the water turning yellow in the tank, try out that bucket test when you do your water changes, and you'll not only get the hang of it, but be acting on data and doing better than most of us. So yellow water's handled, but there are other pollutants you can't see, most notably phosphate and nitrate. If you've implemented a reliable, stable solution for nitrate and phosphate in the first year of reefing, I think you can count yourself in the top 10% of first-year reefers, avoiding a major challenge which often results in undesirable algae growth. My favorite solution for this is called a refugium. The entire 5-minute guide is always available here, but if you want to know what a refugium is, why it's my favorite solution, and how to implement one on these tanks, that's all coming up right here.